Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the channel. This is XRP Army South Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, let me just inform you that I'm not a financial advisor. This is not financial advice. This is only for the educational purposes. Now, Ripple versus Securities and Exchange Commission case update as of May 21st, 2024. As the wait for the final resolution to the long-running courtroom standoff between Ripple and the United States Securities and Exchange Commission is still keeping the cryptocurrency community at the edge of its seat. Ladies and gentlemen, we all know that everything has been filed. We're waiting for the judgment in the remedy phase of this lawsuit. Now, the regulator has responded to the blockchain company Ripple's request to seal a certain information. After Ripple filed its motion to seal a certain document filed in the connection with the Securities and Exchange Commission's motion for judgment and the remedies, the SEC replied that this information should be public. Now, the SEC states that the court should deny Ripple's request to conceal a financial and the security sales information because that information constitutes the judicial documents. The Securities and Exchange Commission does not challenge the sealing of Ripple's recent financial statements as a whole, but where the financial request or specific terms of contracts have been used by the parties to calculate and justify the remedy request, that information should be made public. Legal expert and the popular commenter on the case, Bill Morgan, has pointed out that the Securities and Exchange Commission has acknowledged that none of the XRP sales to institutions with discount were on-demand liquidity contracts. Bill Morgan also said that it remains a mystery why Judge Torres lumped them in with the other contract with the institutions. He said, "I bet the SEC knows that on-demand liquidity contracts are not investment contracts." Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, Ripple earlier filed a motion to seal or redact a confidential information, including the company's negotiated financial terms of its contractual agreements with a certain third party's business partners, with support from its chief financial officer, Jonathan Bill, as Finbold reported on May 14. Now, in early May, the regulator submitted a remedy reply brief. Ripple token at the center of this ongoing battle was at the press time trading at the price of 0.54. Ladies and gentlemen, please don't forget to hit that like. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to follow me on X at Hobby City, XRP Army South Africa. Dankie.